Hello, so happy you could join me again on this beautiful day. I hope it's a beautiful day wherever you're at. I'd like to start out by thanking all my viewers and subscribers and all the comments you've made. I always try to respond back as quickly as I can. Today I thought I would do something similar to stay with the beach theme since I'm from Florida. Today I'm going to try a little bit of a darker water. Maybe have a couple palm trees coming up here. Maybe in the water to be more orange and yellow through the eye of the wave. Maybe a little bit of a beach down here. Some seagulls. Like always, I got 16 by 20 canvas, pre-stretched, spray painted it with different colors with your local hardware spray paint. Make sure you're in a well ventilated area. And I made a painter's tape going across here for the horizon. Then over all that, I put a thin coat of liquid clear. That's going to help the oils go on a lot smoother and make it a lot easier. So that's where I'm at so far. And we'll get started. Maybe get some white in there for the where the sunlight's coming from. I'm just using a little fan brush, just like that. Maybe right in here we'll have something nice and white coming in there. Doesn't have to really be much of anything. It's just, you just want that whiteness, that brightness in there. I'm going to take this blender brush and tap that in. Kind of diffuse it out. Shining. If we can add some more, make it brighter. Tap it. Tap it out. Maybe like that. Who knows? Maybe we can have it go up here a little bit. Maybe the light's going like that. Take that blender brush, tapping it. Kind of diffuses it, kind of blends it more into the sky. Bit more white in the middle. Highlight it more in there. Blender brush. Just the corner. Just barely across. Okay, we got that happening. Come in this maybe we'll come in to some yellow and white, kind of a brighter hue. Maybe we'll run some colors back here, make it brighter. Blender brush, tap that in there. Circular motions, a little bit of tapping. sky happening in there. Maybe a little bit of white up in here also. Maybe here and there. Wipe off that blender brush, come in, tap it. Down here we got something going across there. Just across the horizon. Now, clean the brush off. I used odorless paint there, so it's a good thing. Clean that little fan brush off and go into some pinks. Load it up just like that. Maybe we'll make some illusions of some clouds over here. Maybe some back here. Take the blender brush, wipe off the excess that we picked up before. We'll come in here and tap this. Almost like the way we might do clouds. Take the other side. Maybe where the sun's at. Who knows? Go straight across. Kind of blend that all in together. Now, clean that little fan brush off again. Working pretty good. We'll come into some blue colors. Light blue. Make some clouds. Just like that. Maybe we have a little one right up here. Maybe we got something happening right out here. Maybe it's got a little hole right there. Some things going. clean that fan brush off, or the blender brush off, because it's got all those colors on there. I use paper towels or rags, kind of whatever you have handy. Not the excess. We'll blend this in just like it was, like we were doing the white clouds. Bit of circular motions going on. Some of that. Make it a little darker. Circular motions, trying to make that, create that illusion of the clouds, more of the whiter clouds happening. Go right across. Just like that. Some water lines in the same brush with some white. Just like that. Maybe off in the distance. Maybe we'll come down right where the light might be. Going back and forth. It's barely touching. Kind of like just making a line across. Might get a little thicker and it might be where a wave is. Leave gaps in between, because that makes it look like the illusion Well, there's waves. Got your different layers and different depths of the waves coming in. Now we'll take some orange. Yellows and whites. Just wait. What I'm doing is tapping this. Just with the corner. Just giving it that look. Of it being rough. Wiggly lines. waves crashing in. Off in the distance. Maybe there's one coming in here. Maybe there's one coming in here. Just tap that in, it makes it look like there's a wave crashing over. The illusion. Now we'll come in a little bit of green. Get that look of the ocean. That look where it might be crashing in. Here and there. After you do that, you come into some white, maybe some yellow, and that same brush. Just tap some of that in there. Wipe that brush off and come in and scrape it now. Let me get the eye of the wave out there. On a distant. Maybe some yellows, more yellow up there. Wipe it all off. Tapping it, blending it in. Pull it down on the angle. The angle of the wave. Wipe it off. Pull it down. Blend it in. Blend it in just like that. Gonna come into some white now, and we'll make some water break in here. Where it's turning over. Maybe we can have one coming in here. Maybe some water crashing. Maybe it goes up and down, and I mean, there's a few waves over here. little brush back here. We'll tap some of this down. Make it look like the mist from the water. It's where it's turning over. Over. Maybe this is coming like this here, over that way. It kind of covers that up a little bit. And we can always come in and bring in some stuff in here. Get some things happening. Some of this down. Little lines that you got coming from the waves. Got all the little water things happening. We'll come in and add some of those now. Blend some of that foaminess in. Okay, now we'll come in and maybe we'll have the wave crashing right up here. Also, we'll get some orange, I think. Maybe it's crashing right here. Yellow and white. Right up here. All the way down. Come into some red. Down here. That off, some yellow, orange, up here, shade it in. to look for a little blender brush, something like this here. We'll pull this down, get that dark color fading. Tapping it up there, pulling it down. Get the eye on the wave. Use the blender brush. Tap some white on there for the bottom of the wave. Using this little brush here. I'm going to have it coming up here. We'll dab it in. Maybe it comes right down. Right down and goes right up, right where it splashes up here. We'll come in and tap that in with our brush we used. We use it for bushes too, just the corner. We're going to come in and tap some of this up. What that's going to do is it's going to make it look like it's throwing mist up. Just like that. I'll grab some on the corner. Round the edge off. Just like that. Come in and tap in here. Round that edge off. And come up here now and have it splashing up where the wave crashed in. Who knows, maybe it's splashing all over here where it all turned over. Scatter it around. So we got that happening. And we come into the same colors on this side. Maybe there's another wave crashing in here. Coming in from that side, pulling them down. Some mist up there too. get that where it's come into that white again, little brush, have this come down here. All the way. Maybe it goes, who knows where. Take this brush here, the long one that's rounded off, and tap up some mist. Mist here and there. Could be going way up. Now we can come into some greens. Get some greens happening in here. Get some greens happening back here. Here. Maybe where it's breaking and who knows, maybe you got something happening here. All the way. Different things breaking. Highlight that some more with the lighter colors. Clean off that little fan brush. Blender brush, just barely bring it down. Deeper red down here, I think. Get that shadow going. darken that down there, what it does is it makes it look like a shadows. It makes it look like shadows down there. So you're not going to see that because of the sun, but down here it's going to be dark. Let's pull that. Mist that up. Make it all kind of misty. Crashing over. Clean the brush off again. I'm going to make it lighter. Lighter at the top. Just like that. Right where that's shining through. Maybe along the tops of the wave. Brush, go right across this just a little bit. That illusion. I always step back, you get a different view, different angle. Okay, now we come down here, get some other things coming in. Crashing in. Maybe it's going just like that. We'll take the fan brush. We'll pull it back right from that top. Draw it back. Can add some more. Coming in two different ways. I'm gonna come out here further in front. got going on. Gonna keep a little space there and we'll put another wave in. Okay, what we'll do is we'll splash it up some. Use that little where it's breaking. Some of the waves are coming down. Maybe we got another one in here. Just below the other wave. Just below the other wave. I'll put some more in front of this one. We'll pull that back even darker. Different shades of white where the foam is. It's not always going to be the same. And some more on this. Round it off. Maybe down here this is splashing up. Some waves, some things happening. I'm going to splash this up some more, I think. Make that go right off. Where it's all coming in. Maybe down in here, we'll just have a big one. Maybe this is rolling over right here. Maybe that's just rolling over. Here it splashes. Splashes into, maybe there's a rock there you don't see. Maybe it splashes right there. It does now. Just working on this a little bit more and make it look more foamy. Got that edge there where it's coming in. Who knows, maybe we'll just put something back here. We'll blend that in with the fan brush. Pull that back. Thank you. some water lines going. Then maybe a little closer, we got another little something happening right here. Another little wave where it crashed in. Maybe it's crashing right there. Maybe it goes right off. Maybe we got some color in here coming down. Got some yellows. Hitting right on top. Right on top of the water there. Take this brush here, kind of tap that out. So you get that reflection part instead of that's hitting right off of there. Some yellows, some white, right down here, we'll tap that right in the water. And we'll get some red on the outside, maybe. Blender brush again. I call it a blender brush, but I'm gonna tap this in. You want to get that look from the sun. All the way down. Wipe that off. Into the light colors. Some strictly white. white. Take the blender brush and go right across. A little bit whiter. There. And a few more waves coming up here. Fan brush, pull it back. Just grabbing the very tips of it. Got that going on. Maybe we'll put some beach over here. So go into some brown, some white. More of a white sandy beach, I think. Blender brush that kind of diffuses it, gives it more of a sandy look that we're looking for. It can also come in and highlight a little bit of browner areas. Get a little bit of texture there, a little bit of shading. Blender brush, tapping it in. All the way down to the water's edge. And right there we'll get the palette knife. Maybe grab some blue. Just like that. We'll come in and cut in some water lines. Clean off the fan brush. Come in and pull that. That line gone just like that. Now we'll come back into just some white with the palette knife. A little roll of paint. We'll make a little water's edge. Now we'll take the brush we were using with the white on it. We're going to get some yellows and some greens. We'll go ahead and tap in. Make a little spot here for the palm trees. Right there on the edge. Go into some darker color. With some shadows. Just like that. We'll tap this down where it's got some mini grassy areas coming off down the beach. Just like that. Now, we'll come in and put some palm trees. Do some browns, liquid clear. Get a nice color. Just like that. So who knows? Maybe we'll have one right here. Who knows? Can have one up here. Couple of palm trees. Now we'll come into some white and we'll highlight it. Just tapping it right where they might have that little break in them. Grab some more white for the other one. Just every so often we'll put that on there. Color that in. Break that. Turn the brush over because I got paint on that side. with the little brush here. We'll go ahead and put some seagulls in. Maybe they're down here. There's one. Maybe there's one back here. And who knows? Maybe one over here. Just like that. We'll get some black now. Put the tips, a little bit of black on the tips. Like they have. See, they're right on their beaks. Got a little bit underneath. Right underneath their wings. Okay, got that going on. Take this little brush here that I found is to be very, very good for palm trees. Anyways, the way I think they should look. Load it up just like that. And we'll come in and we'll just tap where we think one might be. Maybe this one comes down there. Maybe we have a few on this one. All I'm doing is tapping it just with the edge. Kind of the harder you tap. Heavier it gets. I found this brush to be the best. For the realness. Of the way they look. Or to me anyways. Maybe this one's got one up here. One here. Down there. Here. There. Wherever you'd like. And you can come back in and start tapping these in. Yeah, little leafy things. They have those each little branch that comes down off the palm tree, kind of individual. Without spending a whole lot of time in detail, which you could do, you have more time to do it. I'm just trying to get this done so you can get the idea. Of the way it might look. Darken this in here. Kind of go around. Just like that, where that fills all that in. Well, looks pretty good to me. I'm going to call this a completed painting. I'm going to go down and get some browns. Could have signed it right in the corner. I always like signing mine with my last name. Other people like to use their initials. I also like to put the year. So I know what I was thinking at the time. Kind of ideas I had. Hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you painted along with me, and I hope you come back and see me. Have a good day. Bye.